Good morning, friends. Today we will see numerical based on loop analysis of unit number 5 decimal network. The numerical is we have to find out current flow through 6 ohm by using mesh or loop analysis. Loop is also called as a mesh, so this analysis method is also called as mesh analysis. Now the numerical is which is having 3 loops. Now in this, how 3 loops? Just see, the first loop is A, B, D and A. So loop A, B, D, A is having resistance 3 ohm, 5 ohm and 2 ohm, which is giving first closed path. So it is called as a loop number 1, and this loop number 1 is carrying the loop current I, 1 in clockwise direction. The second loop is starting from B to C, then D and then again B. So loop B, C, D, B, this path, B, C, D, B consists of resistance 6 ohm, 4 ohm and 5 ohm. This is loop number 2. So this loop number 2 carries loop number 2 current I2 also in clockwise direction. Then loop 3. Loop 3 starts from A to D, D to C, C to A through 10 volt battery. So loop number 3 consists of 2 ohm, 4 ohm and 10 volt battery, and this loop 3 carries loop current I3. It is also in clockwise direction. Now in loop analysis, we have to take care about the voltage drop which is getting across the resistances which are common between two loops, such as now here the resistance 5 ohm, just see, the resistance 5 ohm is combined between loop 1 and loop 2. So this 5 ohm resistance will have the drop due to I1 also and due to I2 also. Here resistance 2 ohm is combined between loop 1 and loop 3. So 2 ohm will carry loop current I1 also and loop current I3 also. 4 ohm is combined between 2 and 3. So 4 ohm will carry loop current I2 as well as loop current I3. So we will have a look step by step how to solve this particular numerical, because we want to find out the current flow through this resistance, that is 6 ohm. Now this 6 ohm resistance is present in loop 2. So current flow through 6 ohm will be loop 2 current. Loop 2 current is nothing but your I2. So when we will solve the numerical, whatever the value of I2 we will get, that will be the final answer, that is the current flowing through the 6 ohm. Now just have a look, just see. This is the numerical we have copied over here. So while solving the equations, it will be easy to have a look. Okay. Now first of all, we will apply the loop analysis to loop number 1. It means we are going to write the equation for loop 1. Now just see, the motion direction to write the loop equation, we are moving in loop 1 again from A to B, B to D and D to A. It means motion is also clockwise, and current also we assume that it is flowing in clockwise direction. So whenever motion and current directions are same, the voltage polarity is always negative, or voltage drop is always negative. So as current is flowing from A to B and we are also moving, that motion is also moving from A to B. So the current is flowing through this resistance is I1. So voltage drop across this resistance is 3 into I1. And as current and motion are in same direction, the polarity of this voltage drop is minus 3 I1. So just see, minus 3 I1. That is the first drop in loop number 1. Now the second drop. Second drop across this particular resistance, that is 5 ohm. Now this 5 ohm is carrying two currents, as I already discussed that. 5 ohm is carrying, first is I1 and second current is I2. Now first of all, we will take I1 drop. Now current flow through 5 ohm is I1. Now current flow through 5 ohm I1 is in downward direction as per the clockwise direction, and we are moving in loop 1 also from B to D, that is again clockwise direction. So the voltage drop across this 5 ohm resistance due to I1 is 5 into I1, and as current is also clockwise and motion is also clockwise, that is B to D. So the voltage drop due to I1 across 5 ohm, that is 5 into I1, will have a minus polarity. So minus 5 I1. Just see. Now we have to even consider the drop of pi ohm due to I2. Now this I2 is flowing in this pi ohm, that is from B to B, and we are moving in loop number 1 from B to D. It means my motion is clockwise, B to D, but the current I2 is flowing in anticlockwise direction, that is D to B. Now just see, we are writing the equation 1 for loop 1. In loop 1, we are moving from B to D. It means we are moving in downward direction. But the current I2 is flowing from D to B. So my motion direction and current direction are opposite. So the voltage drop across this 5 ohm due to I2 current is 5 into I2, but its polarity is positive because motion is B to D, but current is D to B, both are opposite. So voltage polarity will be plus 5 I2. This. Now after D, we are reaching to this 2 ohm in loop 1. Now we are moving from D to A, and between D to A, this 2 ohm resistance is there. So 2 ohm, first of all, we will carry the current I1. So I1 is also moving from D to A, and we are also moving from D to A. So motion and current both are in same direction. So voltage drop across this 2 ohm resistance due to I1 is 2 into I1, and the polarity of this voltage drop will be negative because motion and current both are in same direction. So it is minus 2 I1. This. Now this 2 ohm resistance is combined between loop 1 and loop 3. So this 2 ohm resistance will also carry the current I3. So we have to write the voltage drop across 2 ohm due to I3 also, that is 2 into I3. But this I3 is moving through 2 ohm resistance from A to D. And in loop number 1, we are moving from D to A. It means my motion is D to A, but my current I3 is flowing from A to D. It means motion and currents are in opposite direction. So the voltage drop across this 2 ohm resistance due to I3, that is 2 into I3, but the polarity will be plus. So plus 2 I3. Now again we have reached to A point, where we have started the loop from A point, and now we are reaching to point number A. It means the loop is completely closed and we have considered all the voltage drops. So sum of all voltage drops is equal to always 0 as per KVL, so equal to 0. So this way we have written the equation 1 for loop number 1, that is KVL equation for loop number 1. Now we will arrange the term in such a way that I1 terms first of all together we will write, then I2 terms we will write, and then I3 terms we will write, and then we will equate it to 0. So minus 5 I1, minus 3 I1, that is minus 8, minus 2, that is minus 10. So minus 10 I1, minus 3, minus 5, minus 8, and minus 8, minus 2, minus 10. So first term is minus 10 I1, then plus 5 I2, and then plus 2 I3 equal to 0. This is my equation number 1. Now you can even skip the first step and you can directly reach to the second step. How? As I1 is flowing through loop number 1, and in loop number 1 there are total 3 resistances. First is 3, then second 5, and then third 2. So addition of all these resistance will be what? 3 plus 5 plus 2, that is 10. And as motion is also clockwise, that is A to B, B to D, and A to A, and current is also clockwise, as motion and current both are clockwise, so the voltage drop due to I1 in loop number 1 will be negative. So it is minus 10 I1. In loop number 1 and loop number 2, 5 ohm is the combined resistor. So 5 ohm will have the voltage drop due to I2 also. This is 5 I2. And current I2 direction is exactly opposite to the direction I1 in the branch B to D. So the voltage drop due to I2 in 5 ohm will have positive polarity. And then the 2 ohm resistance, which is combined between loop 1 and loop 3, so it will also carry the voltage drop due to I3, that is 2 into I3. And with respect to I1 direction, I3 is in opposite direction, so the voltage drop will have plus polarity. So you can directly write down this equation, that minus 10 I1 plus 5 I2 plus 2 I3 equal to 0. Whichever is comfortable you, you can have this methodology. Now we will have the second loop. Second loop starts from B to C, C to D, and D to B. So first resistance in loop number 1, we will start from B to C. It is 6 ohm. This 6 ohm resistance is carrying current I2. So the voltage drop is 6 into I2. As motion is also B to C and current is also from B to C, so the polarity will be minus 6 I2. So minus 6 I2. Now we have reached to C point. C to D we will move. In C to D we have a branch 4 ohm. This 4 ohm branch carries two current. One is I2, another one is I3. So first of all we will consider I2 because we are writing the equation for loop 2. So because of loop 2 current, the voltage drop across 4 ohm is 4 into I2. As motion is also C to D and current is also from C to D, I2 direction. So the polarity is minus 4 I2. That is C, minus 4 I2. Now this 4 ohm is also carrying the current I3, which is flowing from D to C. But motion in loop 2, or we are moving in loop 2 from C to D. So motion is C to D, but current I3 is flowing from D to C. For both are opposite, so the voltage drop across 4 ohm due to I3 will be plus 4 I3. Now we have reached to D point. We have to move from D to B to close the path in loop number 2. Now from D to B we have a branch of 5 ohm. In this D to B branch, that is 5 ohm branch, is first of all we will see the voltage drop due to I2, because this 5 ohm resistance is combined between loop 2 and loop 1. So 5 ohm is carrying loop 2 current as well as loop 1 current. Now loop 2 current is flowing from D to B and we are also moving from D to B. So motion and current both are in the same direction. So voltage drop across 5 ohm due to I2 is minus 5 I2. And now the voltage drop across 5 ohm due to I1 we will consider. In this 5 ohm resistance for loop 2 we are moving from D to B. So motion is D to B, but the current I1 is flowing from B to D, so both are in the opposite direction. So the voltage drop is plus 5 I1, and as we have reached to B point, it means the closed path has completed, so it is equal to 0. Again we will rearrange the terms. First of all we have to write I1 terms. As we have seen over here, first of all we have written I1 term, then I2 term and then I3 term. The same rule we will apply for equation 2 also. First we will write I1 term, so plus 5 I1, then we will write I2 term, I2 terms minus 6, minus 4, minus 10, minus 10, minus 5, minus 15, so minus 15 I2, and then last term is I3 term, that is plus 4 I3. So the equation is 5 I1 minus 15 I2 plus 4 I3 equal to 0. Then you can write this equation also directly, as I said that in loop 2 we are writing equation. So in loop 2 the total resistance is 6, 4 and 5. So 6 plus 4, 10, 10 plus 5, 15. You can directly write 15 I2. As we are writing the equation for loop 2, so motion is also clockwise and current is also clockwise. So the associated voltage drop due to I2 will have a negative sign. And with respect to I2 direction, in 5 ohm, the current I1 is flowing in the opposite direction with respect to I2. So the voltage drop is 5 into I1, but will have a positive polarity. Now this 4 ohm resistance is also having I3 current. The current I2 is flowing in downward direction, but the current I3 is flowing in upper direction. So voltage drop across 4 ohm due to I3 will have positive polarity, because current is flowing I3 in the opposite direction with respect to I2. So it will have a plus 4 I3 equal to 0. I think everybody now understood how we can write the equations with the KVL strategy with this fashion. And then the easy method, what I said, we can directly even take the calculation. That also we can write, whichever is comfortable, you can write. So equation 1 also we completed, equation 2 also completed. Now we will see loop 3. Now loop 3 has started from point A to point B, then from point D to point C. Then from point C through this 10 volt battery to point A. Now the motion is clockwise and current is also clockwise, that is I3. Now we will start to write the equation for loop 3. First branch from point A to point D, that is 2 ohm resistance. This 2 ohm resistance carries the current I3. So the first we will write I3 term. So the voltage drop is 2 into I3. as we are moving from A to D and current is also from A to D, so it will be minus 2 I3. So minus 2 I3. Then we will move from D to C. From D to C we are moving, the resistance is coming 4 ohm, the branch will have the current I3, loop current I3 is flowing again from D to C and we are also moving from D to C. Motion and current both are in same direction, so the next drop is minus 4 I3. But as we are moving from D to C directly, we have not considered the voltage drop in this 2 ohm which was again due to I1. So please do not do this mistake. Let's have the look that yes, 2 ohm we have written, voltage drop of 2 ohm we have written due to I3, but we have not completed the voltage drop which was again of I1 also we supposed to write. So please complete the voltage drop of both the currents, the resistance which is combined between two loops. So after writing minus 2 I3, we have to immediately write the voltage drop across 2 ohm due to I1 also. So the voltage drop across 2 ohm will be 2 into I1, and as we are moving from A to D but I1 is flowing from D to A, so motion and current direction both are opposite direction, so the associated voltage drop is plus 2 I1. Let's see. Then we will move from D to C for the next branch, 4 ohm, 4 into I3, moving from D to C and current is also moving from D to C, so motion and current both are in same direction, so the voltage drop is minus 4 into I3. Again this 4 ohm is combined between loop number 3 and loop number 2, so loop number 2 current is flowing from C to D and we are moving from D to C, so motion and current both are in opposite direction. So the voltage drop is plus 4 I2. As we have reached to C point, now we are moving from C to point A through this 10 volt battery. Now from point C, first of all we are reaching to negative plate and then we are moving to positive plate. It means we are moving from negative plate to positive plate. It means from lower potential to higher potential we are going. So there is a voltage rise. As there is a voltage rise, this 10 volt EMF will have a positive polarity. So plus 10 we will write, and then we will move to point A as it has closed the path, so it is equal to 0. So this is equation 3. Again we will write the terms, first I1, then second I2 and then last I3, and then equal to constant we have to write as it is having 10 volt EMF present over here. So always to write the equation, please keep in mind that whenever you want to finalize the equation, the first variable term, then second variable term, then third variable term and equal to constant. In this fashion only you are supposed to write the equations, because we want to solve the equations from the calculator. Okay. So first we will term 2 I1, then second term plus 4 I2, then I3 term, there are 2 I2 terms, minus 2 minus 4, so minus 6 I3. And then this plus 10 we will shift to RHS, so it will equal to minus 10. So equation 3 is 2 I1 plus 4 I2 minus 6 I3 equal to minus 10. So now we have total equations 3, equation 1, equation 2 and equation 3. Then we can take the help of calculator, we can operate the calculator in equation mode and we can get the values of I1, I2, I3 separately. So let's have I1 is coming 1.11. I2 1.11, I3 2.77. So these are the three loop currents value I directly get from calculator, and my final answer is current flow through 6 ohm I supposed to find out. So current flow through 6 ohm is loop 2 current, that is I2 value. So final answer is current flow through 6 ohm is 1.11 ampere, which is of the value of I2 which we have solved in this particular equation. So the current flow through VC or current flow through 6 ohm is 1.11 ampere. I hope everybody understood this loop analysis very clearly. So thank you very much.